Hello, welcome once again. In this video, we want to look at bounded sequences and look at some other issues as far as sequences are concerned. So naturally, when you say something is bounded, okay, you can take the analogy of somebody standing in a room, for instance. So you see that the person is bounded above by the roof and even below. Once the person can't go there, so you say that person is bounded below, by the floor, for instance. But mathematically, when we say bounded sequences, let's take this sequence, for instance. So if we have the sequence this, then for us to say that this is a bounded sequence, then it means that there exists, so for this particular sequence, so for this, then it means that there exists a certain real number n, which is greater than zero, so it's a non-negative number, such that the absolute of this sequence, so it's less than or equal to this particular n. So when you have a condition like this, then we say that this particular sequence is a bounded sequence. Okay, so we can still move on a little. Realize that for this particular one, we can simplify this as we have negative of n, so less than or equal to, so this is less than or equal to n. But because of the beginning here, where we say that m is a positive number or is a negative number, realize that putting the m here as negative contradicts that. So we represent that by small m, so we have this less than or equal to and big m. So we refer to this one as the lower bound of this particular sequence, then the big m here represents the upper bound of the sequence. Alright. So moving on, we want to talk about monotone sequence. So monotone sequences. So what do we mean by monotone sequence? So if we have a particular sequence and it's either increasing or decreasing, so increasing or decreasing sequences are said to be monotonic. Okay, so with monotone sequences, we have monotone increasing and monotone decreasing. Okay, so for the sequence, so given this particular sequence, we will say that this sequence is monotone increasing if we are going to have something of this nature. So this greater than or equal to this. Now what it means is that this particular sequence is a higher sequence as compared to this. So if we look at the relationship between them, you see that the subsequent one, which is a bigger one, is greater than or equal to this. And when you have this situation between two terms of a sequence, then you see that the sequence is monotone increasing. So it's a monotone increasing. Alright. So this particular sequence is monotone increasing. Now the sequence can also be strictly increasing. Alright, so for strictly increasing sequences, the inequality here changes a little. So for strictly increasing sequences, we have this sequence being greater than. So there is no situation where this particular sequence will be equal to this. But in the monotone increasing sequence, it will happen that this should be greater than or equal to that. But when two sequences are said to be one strictly increasing, then we have this greater than, then so we have this to be strictly increasing. So this particular one is strictly increasing. Now, just as we have monotone increasing sequences, we have monotone decreasing. So monotone decreasing sequences, yes, the direct opposite of this. So for monotone decreasing, we have the sequence this, So which is going to be less than or equal to this particular second. So we have this to be monotone. So monotone decrease. Then we will have strictly decreasing sequence. So for strictly decreasing sequence, we're going to have this, and then we have is to be less than that. So that's monotone decreasing sequence. Now let's look at two other concepts in relation to sequences. Where we look at the supremum and the infimum. So we have the supremum and the infimum. So if we have this particular sequence and it is increasing, so the sequence is increasing and it is bounded above by a certain real number, then we say that that particular sequence we can find the soup. So usually we say it's soup, so we have something like this, that the limit of the sequence. So as n approaches infinity will be equal to the sup of the sequence, written like this. So that's the denotation. The sequence is increasing and it is bounded above. Okay, so in this particular sequence, as we have it here, if it is increasing and it is bounded above, then it means that the sequence is convergent. And for convergent sequences, it means that the limit of the sequence as n approaches infinity is a certain number. And that's what we refer to as the sup of the sequence. So we have something like that. Now the other one, which is the infimum, usually it's called as of inf. Then for that particular one, it means that the sequence is decreasing. So if we have the same sequence here and it is decreasing, and it's bounded below, then it also means that the sequence converges. So we have the sequence, so for instance, this sequence. We are using the two so that you know that the sequences can be represented as this or this. So given this particular sequence, which is decreasing, okay, and it is bounded below, well, when that happens, you see that then the limit of the sequence, so as n approaches infinity, will be getting to a certain value, it's converging to a certain value, and that's what we refer to as the inf of the limit of the sequence. So we have something like that. So good. So these are the issues we want to talk about as far as sequences are concerned. Hope you found this one very helpful. Meet me in the next video where we'll talk about limit of functions, okay, and other issues as far as functions are concerned. Thank you very much.